गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर दर्शन अमोरे के कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर नासिक। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी सी अबाउट कल्टिवेशन ऑफ टी। इन दैट वीडियो वी कवर द टॉपिक ऑफ टी कल्टिवेशन इज बॉटेनिकल टैक्सोनॉमिकल डिटेल्स, देन डिफरेंट वेराइटीज ऑफ टी, propagation methods of tea, then planting. In this video we will see the method of propagation, then planting, time of planting, fertilizer requirements, harvesting, etc. So the first is method of planting. There are two types of method, single hedge method and double hedge system. In this in single hedge system, the spacing adopted is 1.25 by 0.75 meter, accommodating 10,800 plants per hectare. And double hedge system, plant spacing is 1.35 by 0.75 by 0.75 meter, accommodating 13,200 plants per hectare. This is in this diagram you can see the different methods of planting. Style of planting, then again method of planting, up and down method, contour planting, single hedge, contour planting, double hedge method. 1.2 meter by 1.2 meter, plant population 6,800 plants. Single hedge planting 1.2 by 0.75 meter, and contour planting double hedge 1.75 by 0.75 by 0.75 meters. Then draining and pruning in tea. Normally tea bushes are established within a month after planting. Within a period of 12 to 18 months they reach a height 6 to 75 centimeters in field plucking stage, and after this stage pruning is taken up. Purpose of pruning in tea is in tea is space utilization, shaping tea to make the best use space of between trees, 15,000 of plants per hectare. Then to induce a vigor in growth and to maintain plants permanently in vegetative phase, re-establishment of initial vigor of the shoot system to stimulate growth. Here, by maintaining the plant permanently in vegetative phase, and it stimulates the production of young shoots. Then to maintain the height of plant plucking table, to facilitate convenient hand plucking of young buds with the tender leaves and shoots at a cheaper cost. To plucking table continues to rise as the age from pruning advance, and pruning assist in keeping the height of the bush within the bounds of easy and efficient plucking. Then to remove the interlaced crisscross branches and disease dried knots and over aged wood. By doing this, the bush will be regenerated. Then to create a congenial microclimate within a plant, provide environment with the plant which is conducive for the maximum crop production but minimize the spread of diseases and pest. Then to maintain the balance of number of branches and sufficient volume of mature foliage to meet the physiological needs of the plant. Drought tolerance, pruning helps in overcoming the drought effect, and it also expose of the bark of frames which had been shed for a few years. Maintaining the quality of tea by rapid renewal of bush flush suitable for manufacture of good quality tea. To minimize the disease and pest attack on tea bush, to pluck the maximum number of tea shoots leaves from convenient height. Then type of pruning, there are different types of pruning. First is skiffing. It is the lightest pruning. Here foliage of lute of only green stem are removed. Here top 5 to 8 cm new growth is removed so as obtain uniform level of plucking surface. If bushes are pruned about 75 cm, it is referred as skipping. In plains of northeast India, tea is pruned every year when bushes enter into the dormant phase. Though this method is no longer practiced, bushes are cut very lightly every year and this is called as skipping. Nowadays, a certain extent do not to skipping every year and leave the bushes unpruned for two successive years. At the end of the prune year, the bushes may be skipped deep, medium, light or levels. Skipping may be repeated 2 to 6 years. Deep skipping is given at a high midway between pruning and tipping heights. In medium skip, the cut is nearer to the tipping height. Say 5 cm below the tipping height, bushes which have been light or level skip are not to tip. Then tipping. It is the first round of harvesting of young shoots. Good frames cloud be developed with the correct tipping. The first plucking of recovering bushes is called as tipping. The objective of tipping is to establish a level plucking surface to provide adequate maintenance foliage for the quick production of secondary branches. Then lung pruning or fringe pruning. Here the crisscross branches are removed so that the bush maintains uniform height. Here all the leaves beyond the pruning level are left, including peripheral branches. In this method, dieback and health of plants is minimized. Death of plant is minimized. Medium pruning to check the bush growing to a convenient height. This type of pruning is a practice. It stimulates new wood and maintenance of foliage at a lower level. It is done occasionally once 12 to 18 years. Medium style of pruning refers to pruning between 55 centimeters. Rehabilitation pruning or collar pruning, 30 to 40 centimeter height. It is deep, heavy, severe pruning done to regenerate the bush when plants become uneconomical to maintain and grow out of hand. Here bush is cut off ground level. Since this type of pruning is more severe, causalities of plants may be high. A pruning height of 30 to 40 centimeter is termed hard prune when primary frames are healthy and if the secondary branches have a numerous knots are cankered, hard or medium prune becomes necessary. In such cases, pruning is turned into the secondary wood. Then shade management. There are different types. The purpose of shade is shade regulation in tea is beneficial effect of shade trees is protection, say then fertility improvement, then breaking of the subsoil layer, temperature effect, summer, wind breaks, erosion. Erosion control and additional income. This is the beneficial effect of shade management. Then also the decrease in pest incidence, UV radiation, increase of soil fertility, the regulation of humidity and minimize evaporation losses. Then there are different types of shade trees are grown in tea cultivation. First is permanent shade trees and second one is temporary shade trees. The spacing of shade trees is different, varies about 6 to 6 meter and which can be later thin out 12 by 12 meter. In the first some years the plant spacing is 6 by 6 meter and then the shade trees are thin out and make the plant spacing is 12 by 12 meter at the age of 12 to 24 years. Then permanent shade trees, different species of permanent shade trees are Albizia species, then Albizia stipulati, Albizia procera, Albizia mulucana, then chinensis, nelibek, silver oak, etc. These are the permanent shade tree species. Then second one is the temporary shade trees. Temporary shade trees, the plant spacing is 6 by 6 meter, and different species of shade trees is Indigofera's, Tismany, then Glericidia, Cypium, Lucenia, Glauca, Erythrina species, etc. In South India, Nilgiri Hills, Silver Oak, Grevillea Robusta is a shade tree of choice planted at 6 by 6 meter and which can later thin out as required 6 by 12 meter or 12 by 12 meter. And the permanent shade trees are attained adequate height. Then temporary ones are removed by gradual looping and uprooting. Shade regulation. In shade regulation and in a tea plantation, shade trees should be looped regularly to maintain the clear trunk up to the height of 8 to 10 meter. The season of looping. At the commencement of monsoon, looping of shade trees can be generally done twice a year. The commencement of monsoon trees of acacia species do not withstand looping, and hence we need very light looping shade trees in the beginning are planted at 6 by 6 meter and later be thinned out by removing altered trees as required 6 by 12 meter or 12 by 12 meter space. Thank you. We will, and remaining part we will see in the next video.